With a fast enough connection, page load animations should look like this. That, according to Greamer, was a single frame. The animation was made in After Effects. We exported it using the Body Movin' plugin. Now we're going to add it to our project so it shows up on the screen and disappears once the page has finished loading. Let's cover this now, and we'll do it in three parts. We'll add the Lottie animation to our project, we'll set up a trigger for when the page finishes loading, and finally, we'll make it disappear. Okay, adding the animation. We've added this JSON file, this Lottie animation asset, to the assets panel. We can drag it in anywhere. Let's put ours right at the top of the page. We can also choose loop, which will play the animation over and over. Let's close out of the settings, and for now, we'll control its position on the screen, by making it fixed. That means it's fixed to the browser's viewport. If we scroll up and down, the animation doesn't care. And let's size it to 100% width. This is 100% of the viewport, and 100% height as well. Just in case, let's also set the Z index, the stacking order, to an obscenely high number. This way, it stacks on top of other content, and parts of the page won't start appearing on top of the animation. And we can also go in and add a background color. When a Lottie asset like this has a transparent background, we can change the background color right here in the style panel. If we preview it right now, it works. Now, how long will this go on for? Well, we tested it, and our theory is it'll go on forever. So this is part two. How can we set up a trigger to hide the animation when the page finishes loading? Let's head over to add an interaction. This is going to be a page trigger. On page load, when it finishes loading, we want our animation to go away. When the page finishes loading, we want to start an animation. What kind of animation? The one we're creating right now. On any of these kinds of interactions, once we create a new animation, we can name it to keep things organized. So once the page finishes loading, we want this thing to hide. We'll make sure the page load animation is selected, and we'll simply set it to hide. We're going to set its display setting, to none. If we preview now, it's maybe a bit too fast. Now, if we were on a slower connection, it might look something like this. But just in case, let's add opacity to this. We want it to fade down to 0%. This means we can fade out the animation over a particular duration, let's say 1.5 seconds. Even though the animation is set to 0% opacity, it's still there. So right after it becomes 0% opacity, we want to set its display setting to none. Display none doesn't just mean it's invisible, it won't even take up space on the page. Completely gone. That's what we want after the page finishes loading. There's no right or wrong way to do this. Some might feel 1.5 seconds is too long. Do we need a fade out? Not necessarily, but we can tweak our values and adjust the animation to get it just right for the page we're designing. Now, one thing to note, it might be frustrating to edit your content, edit the rest of the page, if this animation is floating on top. One thing we could do is set the elements display to none by default. But if we preview that, it's completely blank. The animation never shows up. So if that's what we're going to do, let's go back into that interaction, back into our page load controls, and add one more thing. At the beginning, let's set the display to block. This is the default display setting the element came with. And let's set that as the initial state. This means if we're back in the style panel, we can still edit our page content. Remember, a moment ago, we set its display to none. But when the page loads, the interaction kicks in and shows its initial state. This way, we can still edit everything on the page without it being in the way. But that's it. We added our Lottie asset, we set up a page load trigger when the page finishes loading, and the element's display setting switches to none, so it hides after the page load.